Hi, it's Lili Amanda for Portrait Creatives. In this episode, we are going to talk about actions. Actions in Photoshop is all about helping you to load all the steps you do in Photoshop in order to save you time. For example, if you form your own retouching process, you find yourself always repeat certain steps, then you can always record them as action to run all the steps for you, and that will save you a lot of time. Action is a great way to save time for editing. So let me take you into Photoshop and show you how you can record one yourself. Okay, so we are in Photoshop. This is a beautiful dancer, Nicole. Look at this beautiful image that I absolutely love. You can go ahead, go to Window. You'll find the Action panel over here. And then you will see there's a list over here. For example, if I want to record the step that use curve to do dodge and burn, you can just go to this plus sign, okay, and hit on the plus sign, and you give it a name. I would just say dodge and burn, and start record. And then rest of the steps I do, it will be recorded in this action, okay? It's not about the length of time that you record, it's about the steps you do. So let me just go to curve adjustment layer, and then I would just drag it up. This one is dodge. Okay, that means I want to add highlights in the image. Another one, I would just go for burn and drag it all the way down. Okay, and I'm gonna change it to burn. So these two layers, I will able to do dodge and burn, okay? And then I'm going to invert the layer mask. Okay, and then I'm going to group them by just pressing Command and select the two layers and then drag it to the folder and you'll become group. And I can also name this one, dodge and burn. Okay, and then I go back to the action panel and press stop here. So the steps are recorded. This is the action we just recorded. Let me just remove this. And I select this action and then press play. And then you will see the two layers are added in less than a second. It is super cool, right? And you can not just do two steps. You can do 10 different things if you want. For example, I have an action over here. It's all these steps I use in the image that I constantly use them. So I just record them all and then pick the ones I need. Sometimes I might be, there are 10 steps and I only use 5, but because they are recorded, they play all the steps and I can use any of them. If you update Photoshop, the actions will load automatically. So what if you change computer or you want to give your action to your friend, then you will need to save the action. And you will create a folder, for example, let's just say editing, okay? And then you will need to drag the action into the folder and then go to this menu with the lines over here and choose save actions. And then you can save it wherever you want and click save. So once you change your computer and then you want to load the actions, very simple, just go to this menu again and go to load actions and go to find where you saved the action and you can load it into your Photoshop. Okay, it's very simple and easy. So here's one tip, you can also use a button mode. Okay, click here and there's a button mode. That means all the action become buttons. With buttons, it's super easy to use. Just press it, everything will be done. And I just press this dodge and burn and you can see this two layer just edit it, okay? So this is just today's episode about actions, how to record action, how to save action, and how to load action into Photoshop. And I hope you enjoy this episode. If you find value out of it, please give it a thumbs up and we will be uploading more helpful tutorials. So make sure you subscribe to our channel so you won't miss out any. And I'll see you in the next episode.